Hey everyone, it's me again, and we're going to be doing another test video today. As hinted by the tweet that I sent out, we're going to be doing Diversion, or Deflection as it's better known. So let me turn the volume down. So what we're covering today is... Let me make sure you can actually hear the music. Okay, I guess not. Okay, so just like my image imitated, everyone thought it was mature content, but it's not. It fools you. The image says at the top, What do you think she's doing? Well, she's not. She's licking my muffin. And she's holding out an actual muffin. So, the process of deflection or diverting is exactly the same as it is in war. The first casualty of war is the truth. And it's no different than with chess. So we have to accept that everything that we've been told, everything that we're looking at, is a lie. And so this is one position. It's right to move. Now there's two ways on this particular puzzle that you can divert and deflect a piece away to obtain two separate goals. So the first way, the point is just to move a piece out of the way just so you can obtain the goal better. Maybe set it up this way so you can actually see better. So we have the queen here, bishop, and you know that's just the general overall position. So it's white to move. Can you see how to divert? Okay, so one way it's not letting me go back. Oh well. So the one way is queen takes queen. So queen takes queen. So yes, it's not forced, but black can't exactly not take back because he can't just go a whole queen down. So rook takes queen. Now if you see what that the rook was protecting and see what he's now left behind is the e8 square. Rook comes down and that's checkmate. Because the bishop over here is blocking the only escape square. That is check and mate. So, the other way let's reset this position up again real quick. So, let's just one second. Come on. Alright, so the other way that is not exactly forced, but it is, it counts as a diversion, is when, oh yeah, good point, the knight wasn't there. Hold the rook. One way to force the diversion is rook up to e1, or e8, sorry, give check. Rook has to take. And then queen takes queen. And you go whole queen up. But nothing's better than a win. So if you're thinking that black can just come to e1, give checkmate. Bishop to f1 blocks the mate. So this time the diversion was moving the rook away from protecting the queen. And black's basically lost after this point because they're like a whole queen down. So, the next point this one you're gonna love because it's everyone likes a good old fashioned queen sacrifice. So let me finish. Oh no, the king's in the middle. And now we want black's pieces. King has decided to castle kingside this time. Okay, so, and that's put up. Okay. Missing a piece. That's right. Okay, so this is a fun one. So this version of a diversion is called rerouting. We're redirecting the black piece in the opposite direction from where it needs to go. Now, this one is slightly less obvious. It's slightly harder to figure out, so. I'm going to give you a moment to look at the precision. Okay, so the first move is pawn on a3, takes bishop. It attacks the queen. Black's gonna go, whoa, free rook. And give check. The only move sensible enough is King D2, right? Oh no! I left the attack rook unprotected. Queen takes rook on h1. Well, white goes, well, I've lost two rooks, might as well lose a queen. Queen takes pawn, c6. And gives check. Now, if you look at the position, that would be mate. If only that pawn wasn't there. Pawn takes queen. And then the final part of the plan, bishop a6. Given checkmate. When the queen took the first rook, it was still protecting the a6 square. So by making them take the other rook, it's all the way over here, away from where white was wanting to go. So as you can see, chess is not the most honest of games. Just like in the real version, the opponent could be misleading. So let's have a quick game on this. It's been ages since I played this. I kind of stopped because, well, to be honest, it was one of those that. I got bored because the AI was always playing for a draw. It never tries to beat you, so there was no point in playing. Ugh, this is annoying. I just want to move it so it's. I don't want to go bird's eye view, but I just want it down a little bit. Yes, that was another misleading attempt. And that, folks, is why you never cheat on your girlfriend. Because you'd be lucky if that's all she does. Oh my god, the queen. Whoops. I forgot all about my queen. Again, that's the precision of the board, but... And again, the AI goes for the draw. Well, I got let off there. It just didn't help the position of the board where it was, but... Yeah. There you go. That's slightly better. Ah, and I can zoom in now. Good. So we need to get that rook out the way. So let's see if we can do a little little bit of diverting, shall we? Because queen there is checkmate, you ever noticed? 0 put rook there, check. Rook has to take. Well, it doesn't have to, but... Yay, it worked. Ouch. I smash things. Oh no, it's not checkmate because the rook's no longer there to block the exit. Oops. Oh well. I thought that I forgot that. As you can see, I'm not on my A game. Well, that was close to our diversion. It did what I thought it was going to do. How can you disrespect this crown like that? And yeah, I can still cast a crane sign. Booyah! Oh, they changed it. They used to do high five. Booyah! Oh wow, that was funny, the fist bump. Now I should be able to finish this guy off. Shame I didn't get the rook there first, but oh well. It is what it is. I'll smash you if you disrespect the queen. I guess I have to go here. Get the bishop here, go for checkmate there. I mean, yes, that looks like a bad move, but if I take with the knight, he takes this knight with the rook as another form of diversion. So, I guess this will be as good as any. Oh, we've seen this one. Skip! Pawn takes pawn, I guess. So it's trying to block the check. Well, I must have the free pawn. Like she said, she's not one of those wimpy queens. Once again, it's not doing anything to force the draw. Force the win. It's always, always a draw, and it gets born. Oh, you kidding me? And he wins the fucking queen. He doesn't take. All right, let me think, because this is getting ridiculous. He's clearly not trying to win. Now he's going to take the work and get a check. No? Oh, what a surprise. Doing everything you can to make it even. Bishop and queen, queen and bishop. Thank you. Thankfully, it's game over now. You don't. Back, Kigo. And this is how you shepherd the king. Take your pick, you're getting mated in either next move or in two moves. Let's make sure he's not gonna stalemate. That would be frustrating. But at least now he can move. Good morning. Good afternoon. Good night. If I took, it would have been stalemate. Yay! Let's beat up the old codger. The finger gun! Oh no! She's gonna get suspended from school now. But that is literally the reason why I stopped playing this game, because it never... The fault never works. And, as you saw, it's... The computer, or the AI, just doesn't try to, win, and it's frustrating as hell. So, there you go. That is Diversion. You saw me attempting to do a couple of diversions of the work. It worked, but I forgot the my other work was no longer there, so that messed up. So that's it. That's all about diversions. So chess is a game of war. The first casualty of war is always the truth. So watch out for the pieces, because they may not be what you think they are. See you later. Adios.